Brandenburg. Yung ano?
Mahaba.
Concerto in two, ano, concerto for two violins. Baka wala ka pa na to.
Ay, parang gusto ko masahin.
Pero, I mean,
mamaya.
Pag mga classic
parts and parts.
Dito pa yan.
Paaliw ka dito kasi play sign. For quartet kasi.
Uy, sarap sa mata. Quartet, ginawa pang quartet. Ah, pero ganun pa rin siya.
Ganun pa rin, no? Pero three movements.
Ah, three movements. Pati yung second movement.
Oh,
ay, amazing. Gusto ko yung musical.
Pala din.
Thank you. away this bride in marriage. Can you all take your seats? Who gives away this bride in marriage?
I do. We do. Yes, we do.
Yeah. We do.
Yeah. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together in the presence of God and these witnesses for the union in holy matrimony of Joseph Betanzos and Hazel Joyce and Cantillo. This has been an amazing journey for Joseph and Hazel. And I know that God has an amazing things in store for you both. Congratulations, Joseph and Hazel. And I'm honored and blessed to be part of this important event in your life. In the book of Genesis chapter 2, verses 18 and 25 to 21 to 25, we find in the beginning when God created this world and everything else around us, God has officiated the first marriage between Adam and Eve. God saw that it was not good that man should live alone. So he took a rib out of Adam's side and made Eve and a helpmate that corresponded to him in every way and someone with whom he could spend and build a life together. In these passages, we can see that marriage was God's idea. It was God ordained and God designed between man and woman. It was not man's idea or the government's idea, but it was God's idea. That's why Joseph and Hazel, we can celebrate this important event in your life. Not only because it is wonderful to see you as our friend unite in marriage, but most especially because God is pleased with your decision to commit yourself to each other in marriage. The Bible also reminds us in Proverbs that whoever finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. So Joseph, I hope you know that you are blessed finding your wife here today. You are blessed beyond measure. Yes? Both of you found the one whom your soul loves, and God's favor is upon both of you today. Also, since marriage is God-ordained, marriage is also holy. This marriage is sacred. This is a day to celebrate, but furthermore, this is a day to remember the vows that you will be giving to each other, knowing that these vows were made before many witnesses, and most of all, made before our holy God. Joseph and Hazel, your lives and your marriage are important to God. Therefore, I want to encourage you to remember what God says about the relationship between husband and wife in the Bible. In Ephesians chapter 5, Hazel, the Bible says that wives should submit to their own husbands in everything. This means Joseph is the head of your home, and you will do well to follow his leadership. But Joseph, Ephesians also reminds us that as a head of your home, you should love your wife as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her. You are to be the spiritual leader of your home and you are supposed to honor your wife as a weaker vessel. You should be leading your family to the church to help your future children. The Lord blesses you with the nurture and admonition of the Lord. Sabi nga sa Ephesians 4:32, reminds us to be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you. So Joseph and Hazel, both of you are beginning an exciting new chapter in your lives today. God has many blessings waiting for you, but there will always be times of storms and hardship as well. That's like what we discussed in your counseling. And marahil na experience yun na yan, somehow. No? If you can remember and apply these verses to your marriage, you will be able to weather these storms together with God's help. Joseph and Hazel, remember also what 1 Corinthians chapter 13 says. That love is patient, love is kind, love is not puffed up with pride, and it doesn't dwell on past offenses. Love hopes all things, believes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. Remember that the strength of your marriage is not based on a license or marriage certificate, but on your love for each other. That is what will help your marriage stand the test of time. I want to encourage you both to allow the Lord to build your home, as it says in Psalm 127. Always let your home be a lighthouse and a beacon to those around you because of your testimony for Jesus Christ. You see, for marriage to be as God intended it to be, it is a union of two people who have surrendered their hearts to Jesus Christ. And God is the one who taught us to love by giving His only Son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for our sins. Ayun po yung sabi sa John 3:16, and it reminds us of that kind of love. And I am happy to tell you that Joseph and Hazel have both received Jesus Christ in their lives. More than anything, they want you to know Him as your personal Savior as well. So, they have asked me to share the gospel as well na before tayo magpatuloy sa ating ceremony. And if you were to see what God has revealed through His Word, it is God reaching out to mankind to save him and rebuild the broken relationship through Jesus Christ. The Bible says that salvation is not about religion, but having a right relationship with God through Jesus Christ. And God's message for all of us today is that God loves you and has a wonderful plan for your life. Ano man po ang estado ng buhay po natin, ano man po ang sirkumstansyang kinakaharap po ng bawat isa, God loves us. Amen? Lahat po tayo ay mahal ng Panginoon at may wonderful plan ng Panginoon sa bawat isa. In John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, and whoever believes in Him should not perish but have eternal life." But because of our sins, we are separated from God. And a person apart from God cannot know and experience God's love and plan. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, it says in Romans 3:23, ang orihinal na disenyo ng Diyos para po sa atin ay magkaroon ng maayos na ugnayan sa Kanya. But because of our stubbornness, of our self-will, pinili po natin to go our own independent way, at itong ugnayan na ito ay naputol dahil sa kasalanan. In Romans 6:23, "For the wages of sin is death." And that is what we see, what happened to the first marriage between Adam and Eve. When sin entered, the relationship with God was broken. Before, they were not ashamed. But after they disobeyed the Lord, they were already hiding and ashamed of their nakedness. And in Genesis chapter 3, they were separated from God because God is holy and man is sinful. But there's good news. Jesus Christ is God's only provision for man's sin. God saw our need and provided what we cannot give. Romans 5:8 says, "But God shows His love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." And in John 14:6, malinaw po na sinabi na si Jesus lang ang daan. He is the only way. "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through Jesus Christ." But knowing these truths are not enough. We must individually receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of our lives. Then, we can know and receive God's love and plan for our lives. We are to admit, we are to believe, and we are to commit our lives sa Panginoon. Friends and family members, if you have Jesus in your life, there is forgiveness and promise of eternal life. 1 John 5 verse 12 to 13, "Whoever has the Son has life, and whoever does not have the Son does not have life." And this restored relationship, forgiveness, and the promise of eternal life is not from joining a religion or by doing good works, but by the grace of God through faith in Jesus Christ. Ephesians 2 verse 8, it clearly says, "Sapagkat dahil sa kagandahang loob ng Diyos, kayo ay naligtas sa pamamagitan ng pananampalataya, at ito'y kaloob ng Diyos at hindi mula sa inyong sarili." Joseph and Hazel made this decision personally. They surrender their lives to God and accept God's promise of eternal life as they accept Jesus Christ in their lives. And today, both of them hope that if you haven't made that decision yet, kung wala pa po kayong pagsuko sa Panginoon, they are hoping that you would consider these things and perhaps make a decision today by saying yes to God. Now, I want everybody to please stand as we pray for blessing para kay Hazel and Joseph. And also, if you would like to receive Jesus Christ in your life as Savior and Lord today, I would like to lead you in a prayer. So if you would please extend your hand of blessing para sa dalawa. Let's pray. Lord, we pray for blessing for Joseph and Hazel. Lord, we ask for your grace to help them to keep the vows they're about to make to each other today. And we pray that you establish their family as a testimony of your faithfulness, to sustain them with your grace and protect them, that no man or circumstances shall separate them. We thank you, Lord, for you are the author of marriage, and in you we commit this couple. And for those who want to receive Jesus Christ in their lives as personal Lord and Savior, you can follow this prayer from your heart. Lord, forgive me, for I have sinned. I am a sinner, and I need your saving grace today. I surrender my life to you. Jesus, you are my Savior and Lord. Thank you for saving me. Amen. You can now take your seats. Thank you. Now, as we proceed to the wedding proper, I'd like to share a word first to the couple, then second to the parents, and then to the primary sponsors. In the book of Ephesians chapter 5, just like what we read a while ago, there is loving and submitting. Sabi nga, wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the and is himself a Savior. And for husband, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. These are the two commandments given to the husband and wife according to the passage we just read. Finally, sabi dito, no, firstly, the love that was described was likened to the love of Christ for the church. Joseph, just as Christ gave his life for his bride, Joseph do the same for Hazel. This love also entails leadership, not authoritative leadership, but servant leadership. And secondly, submission to your husband is your role, Hazel. When God created man and woman, he created them both equally. But God's design is that each would fulfill different but significant roles. These roles will help you both complement each other and become the individual, the husband and the wife God wants you to become. Ngayon naman po, para po sa mga magulang ni Joseph and Hazel. Ayan, huwag na po kayong tumayo. Okay na po. As Joseph and Hazel are married today, their goal is to become one in every area of their life. Physical, spiritual, emotional, and financial. In verse 31 of Ephesians chapter 6, meron pong principle na tinuturo ang Bible na ang tawag po ay living and cleaving. They are to live and to cleave. So this teaches that before they can cleave to each other, they must leave. Alam po ninyo, hindi na po mawawala yung pag-aaruga nyo po sa kanila. And there's no question asked about that. Talagang it is evident sa buhay po nila about how you cared for them, how you prepared them for this very important event ng buhay po nila. But Joseph and Hazel, but as they start their own family, allow them to leave. Allow them to learn to stand on their own feet. Allow them to learn from their mistakes and adjust so that they would become more united in this process of growing in their marriage. Alam ko, mahirap po ito. Because you don't want na hindi kayo part ng kanilang decision. But if you really love them, in loving them, you are trusting them. You are entrusting them sa Panginoon, and you are actually trusting them as well to grow together, no? To learn from the mistakes and also to make their own decisions. So can you do that, parents? Yes? And I think you want to honor your parents, right? Just let's start with Hazel.
Ma, Pa, as we start sa new journey namin, we'd like to thank and honor you. Thank you sa support for from small things to big things and sa encouragement. Thank you for raising me and loving me in a caring home. You've molded me into a woman I am today. I am eternally grateful sa inyo. Sobrang mahal ko kayo. Never mawala yung love ko sa inyo. Napalitan lang yung priority, pero mahal na mahal ko pa rin kayo. I love you.
And Joseph?
First is kay Papa. So, Papa, thank you for your sacrifices sa amin. Thank you sa sinet mo example to prioritize family. So, nakailang sulat ako dati kasi pinapareject mo yung managerial position kasi mawawalan ka ng oras sa amin. So, ako, iritang-irita ako nun kasi nga paulit-ulit. Sabi yung rejection na naman, Papa. Bawal ba pwede isang rejection na lang? Pero yun, so super thankful kami na hindi kayo nawala ng oras sa amin. And salamat sa patience mo and sa support na lagi kayong nandyan. And kay Mother, thank you sa love mo and care na whatever happens, nandito ka, kasama ka namin. And salamat sa time na binigay mo sa pag-aaruga sa amin simula pagkabata, nagli-live ka kapag na-hospital kami. And salamat din, yun nga, sa pagiging mabuting ina. At sorry sa mga time na hindi ko na-appreciate yung mga ginagawa mo, pero mahal na mahal kita, Ma. So, I hope na-honor ko kayo ni Papa sa aking life and sa achievements. So, I really love you both. Thank you, thank you.
Thank you. Palapakan mo natin ang mga parents. Para naman po sa mga ninong at ninang, huwag na rin po kayong tumayo. Okay na po. You were chosen because you have qualities in your life and in your marriages that Joseph and Hazel wants to learn. I charge you today to not only show support today in this wedding, but even after the wedding. Nawa po ay lagi kayong handa para gumabay po at umalalay kila Joseph and Hazel, especially when they need your advice as they encounter difficulties in their marriages. Alam naman po natin sa buhay ng mag-asawa ay hindi po laging masaya. May mga times na talagang tatawag po sila ng tulong sa inyo. So please give them advices that would keep their marriages. Yes? Thank you po. Thank you po. Now to the congregation. Kasama tayo lahat dito. You are all chosen, selected by Joseph and Hazel as important guests in this important event in their lives. Make yourself available as well as a community to support and guide them when times are tough in their marriage. Pray for this couple that God will bless their marriage. Yes? Now, can I ask Joseph and Hazel to stand up and hold each other's hand? No other union is tender, no other vows are more sacred than this. You are to assume. I ask you both a very important question. Joseph, will you take Hazel Joyce to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy relationship of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and cherish her in sickness and in health, be true and loyal to her as long as you both shall live?
I do. Yun na, malakas na.
Hazel Joyce, will you take Joseph to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinances in the holy relationship of marriage? Will you love, honor, and cherish him in sickness and in health? Be true and loyal to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Yes. To Joseph, please repeat after me. Hawakan mo yung kamay at tingin ka sa kanya. So I state your name.
Joseph Betanzos.
Now
take you
to be my wedded wife.
To live together
after God's ordinance in the holy relationship of marriage. I promise
to love
and comfort you
honor
and keep you
and forsaking all others
I will be yours
alone
as long as we both shall live. Hazel, repeat after me. I state your name.
Hazel Joyce Ancantillo.
Now take you
to be my wedded husband.
To live together
after God's ordinances
in the holy relationship of marriage.
I promise to love you
honor
and keep you
and forsaking all others I will be yours alone
as long as we both shall live.
Now I know you have your own personal vows, so it's time for you to say your personal vows na matagal mo nang prepare.
Yeah, prepared.
Joseph.
So, ayan, nandito na rin tayo for our third wedding. Sa mga hindi alam kasi, pangatlong kasal na namin to. Since dapat January 9. And ayun, sa lahat naman yun, parehas yung vow ko sa'yo. I vow to love you, respect you, and to be with you for as long as I live. I vow to be patient with you kahit na anong mangyari. Sakyan yung mga toyo mo or kanuman, mga trip mong away. And my promise is that I will never give up on us, like what I did for the past 5 years. So, magkasawa na tayo mukha, or magsama na tayo ng amoy, tandaan mo na nandito ko, narito para sa'yo. So I vow to give my all so I can provide for you and our family in the near future. I vow to make you the happiest girl sa abot na aking mga kaya. You know that I am not the showy type of partner. But I vow to show my love to you using your love language. I vow to lead you to Christ and be a godly head of our family. I love you. I love you. I love you.
Hazel?
Joseph, the day I said yes to being your girlfriend, I am almost 100% sure that you'll be the man I'm going to marry. Ayun, when I was in college, alam ko na kwento ko na to sa iyo. I made a list of the characteristics of the man I want to date. And I prayed for that with all my heart. And talaga prayer works, no? Kasi binigay ka sa akin ni Lord. Ayun, sobrang amazing kung paano in-unfold ni Lord yung relationship natin from strangers to friends to dating ngayon, mag-asawa na tayo. Ayan. As we start this new journey, I vow to always be by your side through all the circumstances this life may bring. I vow to support you, to be by your side, to be your partner in everything, to laugh, to cry, and to be crazy with you. I have loved you, I still love you, and I will always love you no matter what. I love you and happy first Monsary.
I would like to call the ring bearer. The ring is a symbol of the unending and untarnished character of the marriage relationship as God intended it to be. As we look at these rings, we see that there are an ending circle representing the eternal union that God intends for us in marriage. Also, these rings are made of precious metals, representing the untarnished character that God expects us in keeping our marriage's vows pure. And as you exchange these rings today, they are a symbol to the rest of the world that you are giving yourselves to each other and to no one else as long as you both shall live. So Joseph, repeat after me. With this ring, I pledge my love to you today.
I pledge my love to you today.
May it be a symbol of my undying love for you.
Of my undying love to you.
I give my heart to you alone. From this day forward. According to God's holy ordinance. I pledge you this vow. Repeat after me. With this ring, I pledge my love to you today.
I pledge my love to you today.
May it be a symbol of my undying love for you.
Of my undying love to you.
I give my heart to you alone. From this day forward. According to God's holy ordinance. I pledge you this vow. Can I ask you to kneel? I would like to call the veil sponsors. The veil symbolizes the marriage union. Dito po pinapakita na pareho kayong nagpapasakop sa isa't isa. Nakalagay sa balikat ni Joseph as a sign of responsibility at nakalagay naman sa ulo ni Hazel as a sign of her submission. So both are important, walang mas higit sa isa o mas lamang sa isa. We'd like to call the cord sponsors. Now the cord symbolizes the oneness in marriage without losing your individuality. If Joseph, you decide to pull, you see that is, si Hazel ay mahatak mo din. At ganoon din naman Hazel. No? If you pull, damay din si Joseph. Ngayon pa lang, napupull siya.
Tinatry ko lang. Yan.
Kaya nga sa inyong buhay, bilang mag-asawa, you have to learn how to move together. You have to learn how to grow and to enjoy each other. I would like to call the Bible bearer. Now, the Bible is God's word, our manual for life. And I will give this to Joseph. As a symbol of taking responsibility of leading your wife and family spiritually. Would like to call the coins bearer or yung aras. And once again, I would like to give this to Joseph. Joseph, as I give that to you, it is a symbol of taking responsibility of providing for the family. Now, abot mo naman kay Hazel, hindi lang sa'yo yan. Alright. Kaya minsan parang dumadaan lang from lalaki, tapos ibig sabay. No, joke lang. Now, although you have decided na pareho kayong magtrabaho, but the sole responsibility of providing for the family is in you, Joseph. as you entrust the Lord for strength and provision, yung iyong financial needs. And lastly, I would like to call all the sponsors to please remove the veil and yung mga ating mga cords, since they already signed yung kanilang contract, no? So wala na tayong contract signing. It's already signed. Habang tinatanggal po nila, they decided, instead of yung lighting the candle, they decided to do a unity water ceremony. So ito pong water ceremony na ito, just like the Bible describes marriage as the joining of two lives. Yan. Tayo na kayo. As Joseph and Hazel pours their individual glasses of water into this one container, it symbolizes unity and being one in their desire and passion to first glorify God and to grow together in their love for each other. Go ahead. At kung mapapansin po ninyo, yung dalawang mag-ibang kulay merges into one. And just like mixing of water, when they poured into this container, it is impossible to separate the two. So Joseph and Hazel, although this might sound a joke, no, pero if you decided to break your marriage, simulan niyo sa tubig. No? At diyan makikita ninyo na imposibleng paghiwalayin yung dalawa na pinagsama na. So let's all stand as we ask once again the Lord for blessing kila Joseph and Hazel. Let's pray for blessing. Let's all pray. Father, you who presides over the heart and home of all that is good and holy, we ask your special care upon this new journey Joseph and Hazel Joyce are now beginning as husband and wife. May you be pleased to bless their lives together, give them grace that they may find strength in each other, and may they always place their hope in Jesus your Son for every direction they take with their new life. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord, we ask. Amen. Magharap kayo, Joseph and Hazel. Now, Joseph and Hazel Joyce, having pledged these vows to each other today, and through the giving and exchanging of the rings, pwede mong hawakan ng kamay ng isa't isa. Having pledged these vows to each other today and through the giving and exchanging of rings as symbols of your love for each other, upon the authority vested upon me by Sumulong Baptist Church, I now declare you, Joseph and Hazel Joyce, as husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. What therefore God has joined together, let not man separate. So Joseph, you may now kiss your bride. Palakpakan po natin. Friends, I now present to you, harap kayo sa kanila, I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Betanzos. Finally. Thank you.
Okay, we'll take the photos first. Couple and pastor po muna. Couple together with our pastor. Pastor? Thank you, Pastor. Now, couple together with the parents of the bride, please. Parents of the bride. After the parents of the bride, please be ready, all the immediate family. Siblings po ng ating bride, please be ready, you're next. Okay, now, immediate family po. Siblings po ng ating bride. After the immediate family, please be ready, all the relatives of the bride. Lahat po ng mga kamag-anak, bride side, please be ready, you're next, together with the immediate family. Immediate family together with all the relatives po, all the relatives of the bride. Lahat po ng mga kamag-anak, bride side, please. Again, may I call on all the relatives of the bride, please? Sideways po, sideways, facing the couple. Closer. Waki. Thank you, families. Now, both parents, please. Parents of the bride and parents of the groom. Both parents. Okay, thank you. Parents of the bride, you may now be seated. Next, parents of the groom. Immediate family of the groom, please be ready. All the siblings po, lahat po ng mga kapatid ng ating groom, please be ready, you're next. Okay. Okay, next po, immediate family. Mga kapatid po ni Sir Joseph. Ah, okay, salamat. After the immediate family, please be ready, all the relatives of the groom. Groom side naman po, all the relatives of the groom, please be ready. We will join the immediate family after this.